Hello kids, this is your new topic, that is geometry. So first we will discuss point, line, line segment and ray. Point, as you all know, you have done in class 3, a point is the smallest shape in the geometry. It is represented on paper by a small dot. This is point. It is named by a capital letter of English alphabet. So this is your previous work, just small recap is here. Again I read, a point is the smallest shape in the geometry. It is represented on paper by a small dot. It is named by a capital letter of English alphabet. So always take care of that. You have to use capital letter for that. Point P, point S, like that. So line. A line is a collection of points. Now look at here. This is point and this is line. A line is a collection of points extend endlessly. As you all have done in class 3, both side arrowhead, this symbol shows that this side, in both the direction, it has no fixed length. So this is line. After that, we have horizontal line, straight line, oblique, vertical, then line segment, curved lines, rays. So line wise, we will do that. But first, once again, I want to repeat. A line is a collection of points extended endlessly. Means arrowhead here, and this is AB line. Means we have to extend, this is endlessly. Line, it has no fixed length. So always keep it in your mind, railway track. That is line, railway line. No end point, both the direction endlessly extended. That is called line. Here kind of straight lines, horizontal straight line. As the symbol of line is both side arrowhead and name it with English capital alphabet. So this is horizontal straight line. As you daily write in your notebook, that is horizontal straight line. This is vertical, means when you put your scale, we will always say like that, put it in vertical position, that is called vertical straight line. Put it horizontal position, so you have to keep it like that. In my class, I will always use these two words, horizontal and vertical. This is oblique or slanting, means this side, both are oblique or slanting. Whenever we have both side arrowheads, it means that these are lines. So you have to name only, this is horizontal straight line, this is vertical straight line, this is oblique or slanting straight line. A line segment is a part of a line. It has a definite length and it marked by two endpoints, RS. Now here we have endpoint, here we have point, that is endpoint, RS. Horizontally, vertically or slantly. RS is the symbol of line segment, RS. This is the symbol. Line segment is horizontal or vertical or slanting. All of the time, this is the symbol of line segment, ray. It starts from one end point and can extend in one direction only. It cannot be measured. As one said, we have arrowhead. It means that it can extend endlessly. The symbol of ray is this one. Here, one side end point, one side arrow, and XY is a ray. Curved lines are not drawn with the help of scale. These are curved lines, A, B, C, D, E. They are drawn by moving a pencil along with the curved edges like this. These are curved lines. They are drawn by moving a pencil along the curved edge of a coin, a bottle cap or by free hand. More about line, line segment and ray. Intersecting lines, A, B, C, D. They both are lines. And why they are intersecting lines? Whenever two lines crossing each other at a point, that is called intersecting lines. AP and CD crossing and on point X, they are crossing each other at the point X. So these are called intersecting lines. Intersecting line segment, that is same. Here we have line, means no fixed length. Here we have fixed length. So these are lines, RS, line segment. XY, they both are line segment. They both are crossing each other at point N. So this is intersecting line segment. Perpendicular line. Perpendicular line, when a vertical ray line or line segment meets a horizontal ray line or line segment, they are formed perpendicular line. again I speak, when a vertical ray, this is line. Whenever it is line, ray or line segment. When a vertical ray, line or line segment meets a horizontal line, ray or line segment, perpendicular lines are formed. So these type of lines are called perpendicular lines. So it may be ray, it may be line, it may be line segment. When they meet on like that, this is called perpendicular. So CD, example the letter CD, that is called perpendicular. Parallel lines, lines which never meet are called parallel lines. AB, CD, they both are parallel lines. Line which never meet are called parallel lines. They are always at an equal distance. They are always at an equal distance and they never meet. Again, intersecting lines AB and CD are intersecting or crossing lines. They are crossing each other at point X. Same here. Here we have line segment RS, XY line segment crossing each other at point N. Perpendicular, it is ray, it is line segment, meets a horizontal ray, line or line segment, that is called perpendicular. Parallel lines, lines which never meet, they are called parallel lines. But very important part for parallel line is that they are always at an equal distance from each other. They are always